What's happening, guys? Dan Debenham here, and today we're doing a really quick tutorial on two things. That is drawing a line on After Effects in a composition, and that means you can grow a line across, so they've got titles and lines underneath it, etc. Whatever you want to do with those lines, this will show you how to do that. And also using stroke in order to write a line onto a composition, meaning you can use it in videos for maps and things like that. You've seen it on these things where you see a map line draw itself along the route and what have you, and then pop up and things pop up, like pins pop up and such like. And these tutorials are really easy to do, but they're so effective, and they give you just a really nice finish so that your viewer can see what you're pointing at, what you're doing, and how you're doing it. So let's get into it. Okay, so we're in After Effects now, and we are looking at drawing a line on here, so we've got our timeline open. We're gonna go to a new layer, and we're gonna do a new solid layer. And the reason we do a new solid layer is so that we've got something for this line to attach to. Because when you're doing a stroke line, the line is effectively drawn onto the picture that you're viewing. So your video would be in this situation. If it was a map, it'd be a picture of Google Maps or whatever map system you're using. In this case, it's red. So we're gonna draw on a line here. On a stroke, we pick our pen tool, draw a line, and whatever shape you want it to be. It doesn't have to be a particularly straight line or anything like that. This is just a really quick detail that we're gonna use. So we'll draw that on there. That's now in our timeline and is there on ready for us to use. As you can see, we clicked off it and it's disappeared. Click back onto it and you can see the line has appeared. Go up to Effect, Generate, and then we go to Stroke, and you can see the stroke's appeared. Now in that corner there, we've got our stroke ability, effects controls. So we're gonna make that a 12-point line just so we can see it. We can change the color, brush hardness, opacity, etc., etc., paint style, and so on and so forth. From here, we're gonna leave those as they are. As you can see, it does nothing when I scrub through the timeline. And once we've done that, we've got that sorted, what we're then gonna do is we're gonna go up to the end point and put a keyframe in, and we're gonna reduce it to zero. At that point, we're gonna move across to however many seconds you wanna be or wherever you want it to end. So wherever you want your line to be fully seen, so we can see it. And we go back to the end point and we put it up to 100%. So now we've got 100%, we'll hit play. And as you can see, the line draws straight on there. And it will just continue drawing on there until it gets to the end point that we've set. And at that point, your line is done. And that is pretty much it for that particular way of doing things. So as I say, we'll recap it. Basically, you need to put a solid layer or a picture underneath it because it's a stroke. It's not actually a piece of graphic in itself. And you draw your stroke line on, and then you're using the end point. So you put a keyframe at the beginning and set it to zero, and you put a keyframe at the end and you set it to 100%. And at that point, it will then basically opacitate the line on from zero to 100%, whether that's straight, curved, got angles in it, etc. It doesn't have to be curved, it can be straight curve, it can be a straight angle if you want it to be, if you go down roads and things like that, whatever it is you do with it, and it can be any particular shape. So, second one is growing lines, and that is where we get a point and we use the center point or the center point tool in order to be able to set the center point from where the line will grow from, and it will grow out either side, so basically the line gets longer as we go on. So let's move on and have a look at that. Okay, so we're back in After Effects now, and we don't need a layer for this particular section because this is a shape. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna just click in here and we'll do 2 points, and we've got it, there we go. So this shape is in place now. And so now we've got a shape. What we can do is we've got it in our timeline. You can see, we just click out, down, expand it, go into transform, into shape, and then into transform shape. And we'll go to the stroke and we'll make that so we can see it. So we're now in stroke width, get rid of that. It's all done, let's close that down a little bit. Okay, so we've now got that and we've got it on our timeline, we've got all the settings set how we want them to be set, and we're looking at scale. So we need to unlink scale, and the reason we unlink scale is because we want the length to grow but not the width, and if we don't unlink them, the length of the line will basically just get bigger and closer to you effectively. So once we've done that and we've got all that sorted out, we hit Y on our keyboard and then we move the center point to the middle, as you can see, And that means we're now in the situation where the grow point is at the middle, and then we highlight the scale and set it to zero. We then move along into wherever we want to be, and we then set the center point scale to be 100. And at that point now, we've got two keyframes, one at zero and one at 100, with the grow being from the center. And as you can see, if I play it back, it just grows out from the middle or wherever that center point would be into a full line. And again, that is it. It's really, really simple. There's not a massive amount involved in that. It's basically just a straight, wherever you put that center point, it will grow from that point. So it will grow from there, it'll stop and carry on growing, or it'll grow from the middle or wherever it is. So it's quite important to get the center point in the middle if you want it to grow evenly out either side. And there are several different ways of doing that. You can get a center point alignment tool and align the tools, you know, do it automatically for you. Or you can do it by eye, as I did, by holding down Y and then moving the mouse about, and that will do just as good a job. However, it's very, very easy, and that is basically all I've got to say on it. It's quite easy to do. Give it a go, try it out. Let me know if you've used it in anything, and copy me into that, you know, link me into that, and I'll have a look at it. It's absolutely great tool to use. I do find it very, very useful. So if you did find this useful and you thought it was a useful tutorial, do like and subscribe below, and I will see you guys next time.